Hello there, welcome! We will see here how to make 3D text with Adobe After Effects CC. Leave feedbacks if you find mistakes in pronunciation. Let's suppose to have this simple text. There are many ways to create 3D text. I will show you a very simple one. It won't matter any color or gradient applied on the source text. Create a new solid layer, right-click on a vacant space and then go to New and then to Solid. Decide the color below, then accept with OK. For this solid, make sure to use the same size of your project. The aspect of the future 3D text is the one of such solid layer we are going to use. To personalize it properly, you can add some effects. For example, if you want to change its color, add the hue saturation effect. You can use gradients too. For example, you can use the gradient ramp or the four color gradient. Once done the aspect, let's create from this solid layer the 3D text. To make all work later, include the source 2D text inside a composition. You can simply right-click on the text layer and go to Pre-compose. Then add the shutter effect to that solid layer. This effect, as it is by default, is far from being a 3D text one. Indeed, this can be used for this purpose. Put in view rendered. In shape section, choose custom and the text pre-composed made before as custom shutter map. The shutter map is the shape given to such effect. If you choose the text composition, the text will be rendered in 3D, but it will still behave as a shutter effect with motion. To stop motion, just go to Force 1 section and choose an high value for depth. Remember to hide the 2D text. To set the point of view of such text, just add a new camera layer and select it in Camera System section. Then use the Unified Camera tool on the preview. You can move the 3D text like a normal layer, holding Ctrl down and dragging to move and scale using the squares. To adjust the extrusion, simply change the value of the extrusion depth in the shutter effect control. Your 3D text is fully represented by the solid layer, so hiding, locking, or moving it means to do the same for the 3D text. Never delete the original 2D text, or you will lose the 3D text as well. Simply leave it hidden. You can add effects for sure. Simply click and drag them on the solid layer itself. Let's suppose that you mistake and you need to correct the text content and its aspect. To change the text content, simply come back to the original 2D text and change it. Since this text is the source text of the 3D text, the adjustments will be applied immediately. And what about changing the aspect of the 3D text? Simply enable the shutter effect of the solid layer and change then its aspect. If you change its color or add any gradient, this will later happen to the 3D text too when you activate the shutter effect again. What about adding a customized pattern or something more complex? As long as you use the solid layer to create a 3D text, you can change the 3D text aspect by changing the aspect of the solid layer. If you want to add a new pattern through an imported picture, so an external file, you need to use a composition instead of a simple solid layer. What does it mean? Let's have our 2D text to convert into 3D. This time, instead of using a solid layer, create a new composition right-clicking on the vacant space in the project panel. Make sure to use the right resolution not to lose quality. In this new comp, add anything you like, a picture, objects overlapped, or even a video. Then simply add the shutter effect to this comp, using the same settings for view, custom shutter map, and force depth as seen before. You will see that, this time, the 3D text is done through a composition, with the same aspect of this comp. You can personalize much deeper a composition, and so the 3D text itself. If you aren't satisfied yet, you can add a special shadow and light effects. Select the layer that represents the text, so the solid layer or the comp, and then go to layer section and then to 3D layer. This will convert it into 3D. This action must be done if you want that the next step works. Then right-click on a vacant space in your timeline and go to New and then to Light. Choose the kind, the color and its properties. Then, using the selection tool above, move the light where you want it to be placed and set its target. To add shadow instead, the simplest way possible is to use the drop shadow effect that you drag on the layer that represents the 3D text. Pay attention that this shadow is independent from the light used, so you must set it manually. I hope this video helped you out. Check the other videos in this show to go more into Adobe After Effects CC. Thanks for watching.